Hello, this is Bern, and today I'm going to share with you how you can meet your soulmate much faster than your current path. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can attract the kind of man you want and step into the relationship that you've dreamed of as a result of being your true self, the most feminine and radiant version of yourself. No need to play gimmicks or games or manipulate in any way. Now, if you wanna get to meet your soulmate much faster, I'm gonna share with you one thing you can do right now. Number one is, typically when you connect with a man and he's someone that you feel attracted to, this doesn't happen when you're not attracted to the guy. It only happens when you're really attracted to him. There's gonna be a firing mechanism in your brain that will attempt you to save yourself from embarrassment, from fear, from anxiety, from rejection. And when that takes place, a thought will creep into your head like, oh, he's so conceited, or he is so full of himself, or something that may have zero basis in reality, but will become the perfect excuse for you not to put yourself out there and do what you have to do to create and establish a connection. In other words, your brain is trying to save you from potential pain, but in trying to save you from potential pain, what you're doing is you're judging him, prejudging him in a way where you won't get a chance to connect with him. So here's a few steps you can take so that that doesn't happen and you radically increase your chances when prompted, when faced with a guy that you feel is attractive, interesting, good looking, has his shit together, that you can create a connection. First one is stop the judgment for a second. Maybe he's a royal a-hole or something, but maybe he's not. Maybe he is not paying attention to you right now because he hasn't seen you. Maybe he's thinking about problems that he has right now in his job or personal life or something of that nature. But if you look at him and you say, well, he's not paying a lot of attention to me, therefore he's not interested in me, that's probably a wrong assumption. So what I want you to do is, after you stop judging, is that you drop the handkerchief fully. Here's what this means. If you dropping your handkerchief means that you typically kind of, from a faint distance, smile a little bit so subtly that he can't even distinguish it, then you need to make a bigger, bolder smile directed towards him. Okay, so you go from maybe looking down to looking up. If you're already looking up, then you smile. If you typically smile with not too much enthusiasm, you smile with your full self. If you already smile with your full self and it's not working out, then the next step is maybe you say, how's your day going? You take it upon yourself to make this human being feel welcome in your presence. You're not pursuing him. You're not asking him for his number. You're not telling him, please ask me out. You're simply making sure that you are dropping the handkerchief at such a clear level that if he chooses not to take action, it's not on you, it's on him. Because otherwise, if you half-assedly drop your handkerchief and he doesn't recognize it and you say, well, he's rejecting me, he may not be rejecting you. He may be rejecting the half-strong attempt that you made at connecting. And he doesn't take it as she's interested in me. He takes it as she's just being polite. So make it unequivocally clear that you're open to connecting if he's interested in connecting. Does that make sense? Next step is when you take it to the next level, when you're more open, more courageous in expressing your smile, more forthcoming in saying hello or asking a question, if the man chooses to ignore you or if he chooses to turn around or if he's like just dismissive of you, I want you to not take it personal. Why? Why am I saying this? Because the guy could be married, he could be gay, he could be in a relationship that's not marriage but still committed. He could be, there's so many different situations that could be taking place other than he doesn't like you, that I'm going to urge you to take the position that I'm not going to take this personal, but I will develop through doing this. Two things that I will never develop if I take my current stance. First one is you're going to get better at stepping into courage in life. And this courage is something you can use in multiple situations that have nothing to do with men. So if you're the kind of woman who puts herself out there, smiling, radiant, expressive, drops her handkerchief constantly, and the guy chooses not to connect with you, you're getting more courageous. The next guy who gets you, the guy who becomes your husband, your future lover, is going to benefit from a far more courageous woman who speaks her truth consistently without fear, or with some fear, but still with strength. Second one is you're gonna live a life with zero regrets. So think about it this way. You gave yourself every single chance you could to connect with the kind of man you wanted to connect with. If for any reason it doesn't happen with any of them, you can die happy knowing that you did your absolute best to create that connection. If you look down when you were supposed to look up, if you stopped making eye contact, if you didn't smile, if you didn't say hi, if you didn't do all those things and you didn't get the love you want, then it's on you. Because you missed out on probably thousands of opportunities throughout your life that you could have completely made to your benefit. Have you taken more time and more courage to do the things that are uncomfortable but can help you get exactly what you want? I'll share with one more thing at the end. All it takes is one connection to go from single to in a relationship. One connection. So even if you've made 100 over the last 2 months and they haven't played out, the one you make today can make the difference between you being engaged 1 year from now and getting married or you staying single again. Just keep that in mind. If you find this is helpful, useful, insightful, I'm going to ask you, my dear, to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Click the little bell to be notified of new episodes. Number three, on the first link in the description of this video, I'm going to share with you on a free masterclass how you can get into the kind of relationship that I'm speaking about with a lot more ease and a lot less pain. And finally, if you want my help and handholding, the second link in the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting, and as always, I challenge you to live a full, a conscious, and a super fulfilling life.